Hello once again. Today let's talk about Hadoop streaming in Python. The goal of this particular session is to introduce you to Hadoop streaming library, which ships with Hadoop software, so which is a mechanism to run MapReduce programs written in non-Java language on Hadoop. Then we'll walk through the MapReduce code that is written in Python, mostly mapper and reducer programs. Then I'm going to show you how to execute or test your Python code on the local file system as well as on the HDFS. So for the testing purpose, I'm going to use the Cloudera VM to run the Python examples on HDFS. So if you're not familiar with Cloudera VM, please look at one of my videos on how to set up Cloudera virtual machine on Windows. Before jumping to the examples, let's understand a bit of Hadoop streaming. So what is Hadoop streaming? Hadoop streaming is a utility that comes with the Hadoop distribution. It's a feature that allows developers to write MapReduce applications using languages like Perl, Python, Ruby, etc. So it can be any language that can read from the standard input and write to standard output. Even though the Hadoop framework is written completely in Java, programs for Hadoop need not be coded in Java, but can also be developed in other languages like Python or C++. So in particular, Hadoop streaming is available since the version of Hadoop 0.14.1. In this demo, I'll show you how to develop the MapR code in Python. And for anyone who is interested to understand more about the Hadoop streaming and the various options, I'm going to share you the link, so which is available on hadoop.apache.org, and you can check the latest documents. So here I'm just referring to 1.2.1 version, and the latest one is 2.6 or something. So obviously in this particular link you can see what the various options that you can use with Hadoop streaming and also some test examples. So let's get started. Currently I'm on my Cloudera VM. Let me maximize this. And as you understand, every MapReduce has two steps. One is a mapper step, which takes the raw text or a document and converts it into a key value pairs. And here in particular we are going to write a MapReduce for a word count. Each key in our example is a word, and for that purpose I'm going to use an input of this particular type, which has some random strings: cat, mouse, lion, deer, tiger, elephant, etc. So in this example, each word will be a key, and the mapper is going to read the complete text file, take out every word and write that output with a value of 1. And the final step, which is the reducer step, it is going to combine all the duplicate keys. So when I say duplicate keys, repeating words like, as you can see, lion is repeated thrice in these two lines. So it's going to combine all the duplicate keys by adding up all the values. Since every key here or the word has a value of 1, so it's going to aggregate the total for each of the word, how many times it was found in the input text. And finally, it's going to print the key, so which is a word in our case, and the total number of count on the standard output. So let me show you the mapper.py, which is the Python code. So here is our mapper.py, and as you can see here, we are going to import a system module because we need to read the data on the standard input and write to standard output. So I'm going to read the entire line from the standard input, and I'm going to remove the leading and trailing white spaces using the strip command, a strip method, and then I'm going to split the line into words on this vertical line. So basically, once the data is split, let me open the input file so that you understand better. So once the line.split is done on the first line, the words is nothing but an array of different words, basically cat, mouse, lion, deer, tiger, and lion. And finally, we are just looping over the words array and printing the word with a count of 1 onto the standard output with a tab in between. So before moving on to the reducer logic, we can actually test this on the local file system, which is one of the fastest ways to test it. You don't have to put this on HDFS, copy your input file and test it. That's going to take a longer time. So how do I test it? I can say cat, my input file, and pipe it to mapper.py. So as you can see, according to our logic, it should count every word and with a value of 1. So the mapper is working exactly as needed. So let's move to the reducer code. So this particular reducer code is going to take each key and sum up the values for that particular key before printing to a standard output. So as you can see, we are importing the sys module and the item getter, and we're just defining our current word and current count to 0 and none. And again, this particular code is going to read the lines from the standard input. It's going to strip the leading and trailing white spaces. And on this particular line, you can see that we are splitting the data based on the tab. So if you remember, in the word count mapper.py, we are outputting the word with a tab and the value. So we are going to split that so that we get the word and the count separately. And as we go down, we are going to add the count for each of the words. And then finally print the word and the value with a tab in it. So now, as we have seen the reducer code, we can test the entire flow by simulating the MapReduce sorting as well. So I'm going to pipe the mapper output to sort -k1, 1, and then to python reducer.py. And here, as you can see, the output of the mapper.py was given to sort so that it is sorted in A to Z manner, and then it is outputted to reducer.py, which actually gone through each of the key and values and then finally aggregated the results of how many times each word was found in the input. As you can see, our logic is working fine. We can test it on the HDFS. So again, as you remember, to test on a HDFS, you need to put your word count into HDFS and say HDFS DFS -put word input to user Cloudera. So before executing the code from HDFS, you need to understand the location of the Hadoop streaming jar. So this Hadoop streaming is available under user lib Hadoop 020 MapReduce contrib streaming, Hadoop streaming, and your version of Hadoop and the jar. So this is the library which is going to execute your Python code. Let me copy this particular line, and I'm going to execute Hadoop jar, paste the complete line, and here you can specify MapRedue.reduce.tasks. So you can specify how many reduce tasks you want to execute, basically two or three or one. So I have a smaller file, I'm going to use a one. And I'm going to specify the location of the mapper and the reducer using the file option, which is available under Home Cloud Era, Mapper, Home Cloud Era Reducer. And with hyphen mapper option, I'm going to specify which of these scripts is my mapper. And with hyphen reducer, you need to specify the reducer code. And hyphen input, I'm going to specify the input file from HDFS. User cloud era word input, and with hyphen output going to specify the output location within HDFS, which is under user cloud era word cloud output. Okay. Error streaming stream code. Okay, let's execute once again. Okay, looks like my previous command had some error in it. So as you can see, the streaming had packaged my mapper.py reducer.py into a jar file, which is created on into a temp location, temp streaming, and it has completed the job as well. Let's look at the output here in HDFS. I'll just do a cat on this. As you can see, the output on our local file system as well as on HDFS is the same. So this is the same way you can actually create your MapReduce programs in Perl or Ruby or Python or in other languages and test it out and productize it as well. So thanks for watching. Have a good day.